टुडेज लेसन एक्सरसाइज 10.2 मेथड ऑफ सब्स्टिट्यूशन। मेथड ऑफ सब्स्टिट्यूशन। At first definition, the process for integration in which any function in the integrand is substituted by a variable is called method of integration. Let the function fx is replaced by variable z. Now z is equal f of x, therefore dz by dx is equal f prime x. This is the first derivative in both sides. Now integrating both sides, of one with respect to x, we get integration dz by dx is equal integration f prime of x dx, implies that z is equal integration f prime x dx, implies that integration of dz is equal integration f prime x d of x. Since the result of integration of dz and f prime x of dx are equal, they are equivalent, that is dz is equal f prime x dx, therefore dx is equal 1 by f prime of x dz. So dz is used instead of f prime x dx. If one number, if a, b, n are constant, and n not equal minus 1. Then find integration x plus b whole to the power n dx. Now solution. Let x plus b equal z implies that x equal z minus b, therefore x equal 1 by az minus b by a, therefore dx is equal 1 by a d of z. Therefore integration x plus b whole to the power n dx is equal integration, at first we let x plus b is equal z, x plus b is equal z, therefore z whole to the power n, x plus b whole to the power n, that is z to the power n. Now another one we get dx is equal 1 by a dz, therefore instead of dx can write 1 by a dz to 1 by a dz. Now at first we separate constant term in front side of integration sign, 1 by a integration z to the power n dz. Now it is the first formula of integration, that means integration x to the power n dx is equal x to the power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c, therefore 1 by a into z to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus c. Now we put the value of z, 1 by a into z is equal x plus b equals z, therefore z equal x plus b whole to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus c. Now you can write down a into n plus 1 x plus b whole to the power n plus 1 plus c. This is the answer. Now this is called formula in this chapter, first formula, integration of x plus b whole to the power n dx is equal x plus b whole to the power n plus 1 divided by a into n plus 1. Now you can remember it, the function is x plus b whole to the power n. The function is x plus b whole to the power n. In this case, at first you write down as like as this formula first. Here x to the power n dx. That means x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. So, if this is x, then its integration x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. If this is x, total term is x, x plus b is x and its power is n, then you apply this formula x to the power n dx, x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. So x plus b whole to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. Now here look at, this is a function here. There are two terms, its first term ax, that means coefficient of x is a. Now we divided this coefficient of x is a. So x plus b whole to the power n plus 1 by a into n plus 1. Now you can easily memorize it or remember it, these types of integration formula. X plus b whole to the power n plus 1 divided by coefficient of x into n plus 1. Similarly, we find sine integration sine of x plus b of dx. Now, solution, let x plus b is equal z, implies that x equal z minus b, therefore x equal z by a minus b by a, therefore dx equal 1 by a d z. Therefore integration of sine ax plus b d of x. Now integration sine, the value of x plus b is equal z, that means sine z and value of dx. Now sine x plus b, x plus b is equal z, sine z is cut. Now value of dx is equal 1 by a d of z. Now constant term 1 by a, integration sine z dz. Now you apply the formula of integration of sine x dx. We know the formula of sine x dx, integration of sine x, that means minus cos x, here sine z. So minus 1 by a sine x, that means minus cos, minus sign, then cos, here z, cos z plus c. Now minus 1 by a cos of z, z is equal x plus b, x plus b plus c. This is the answer. Now how can we memorize it or remember it? For formula, sine of x plus b dx, integration of sine x, sine x plus b. Now we know if this is x, total term is x, then integration of sine x minus cos x. Now minus cos x plus b and coefficient of x is a, now divided by coefficient of x, that means 1 by a. again I repeat it, if this x plus b is equal to x, whole term is x, that means integration sin x dx. We know the integration of sin x dx is equal minus cos x plus c. So minus cos this term, and here coefficient of x is a, now divided by a. Now this is the second formula. Similarly, three number, integration of cos x plus b dx. We know integration of cos x, that means sin x. Now sin x plus b, because here after cos x plus b, so after sin x plus b. Now here coefficient of x is a, therefore divided by 1 by a. Now integration of cos x plus b is equal 1 by a sin x plus b. Now listen carefully. For this exercise, at first we revise the trigonometric formula and related of this chapter formula or exercise formula. Now we revise the formula. In this exercise, now formula 1 number, integration x plus b whole to the power n dx, where a, b, n are constant and n not equal minus 1, is equal x plus b whole to the power n plus 1 by a into n plus 1 plus. It's very easy. Now look at the formula. This is the function. Now its power is n, so n plus 1 divided by n plus 1, and coefficient of x is a, now divided by a. Now formula 2, integration sin x plus b is equal, for sin we know minus cos. Now minus cos of x plus b, and here coefficient of x is a, now divided by a plus c. Now three number, integration of cos x plus b dx. We know integration of cos x, that means sin x. Now sin, here this is, if we consider total is x, that means ax plus b. Now for coefficient of x is a, now divided by a plus c, and similarly our formula. Now we revise trigonometric formula. 2 cos square x 2 cos square a is equal 1 plus cos 2a 2 sin square a is equal 1 minus cos 2a sin 2a is equal to sin a cos a sin 3a is equal 3 sin a minus 4 sin cube a cos 3a is equal 4 cos cube a minus 3 cos a and another 3 formula two sin a cos b is equal sin a plus b plus sin a minus b 2 cos a sin b cos a sin b sin a plus b minus sin a minus b now 2 cos a sin b sin a plus b minus sin a minus b and last one 2 2 cos a cos b 2 cos a cos b cos a plus b plus cos a minus b 2 sin a sin b cos a minus b minus cos a plus b now first 2 formula you remember it for cos square plus sin and sin square minus sin 2 cos square 1 plus cos 2a 2 sin square 1 minus cos 2a that means for cos square plus and sin square minus and you observe the last formula 2 sin a sin b here cos a minus b minus cos a plus b but here cos a plus b sin a plus b sin a plus b but in case of 2 sin a sin b cos a minus b now we start the exercise maths of 10.2 Here exercise 10.2 question number 1 integration 5x plus 3 whole to the power 6 dx. Now we use the first formula, integration x plus b whole to the power n dx is equal a into n plus 1 x plus b whole to the power n plus 1 plus c. Here coefficient of x is 5, that means a is 5 into n is 6 plus 1. Now 5x plus 3 whole to the power 6 plus 1 plus c. Again I repeat it, the function is 5x plus 3. Now write down 5x plus 3 and its power 6 plus 1 divided by coefficient of a, that means 5 into n plus 1, that means 6 plus 1. We calculate it, 5 into 7 35, 1 by 35 5x plus 3 whole to the power 7 plus, this is the answer. Similarly, two number, integration 1 minus x whole to the power 7 d of x. Now here the function is 1 minus x. Now you can write down 1 minus x, now here power 7. Now that means n plus 1, 7 plus 1. Now we divide it by the coefficient of x is here minus sign, so minus 1 into n plus 1, 7 plus 1. Here we use the first formula. Here coefficient of x is a, here coefficient of x is minus 1. And n plus 1, that means 7 plus 1, 7 plus 1 plus c is equal minus 1 by 8 into 1 minus x whole to the power 8 plus c. Now similarly 3 to 6, try yourself. Now question number 2. Twice 2. Integration dx by root over x plus 1 plus root x minus 1. In these types of math, at first we multiply in both denominator and numerator by the denominator. Here again I repeat it, in these types of math we multiply both denominator and numerator by the opposite sign of denominator. Here root over x plus 1 plus root over x minus 1. Now look at this, here plus sign, so we multiply this term, but here sign is minus. And this root over x plus 1 minus root over x minus 1. Now root over x plus 1 minus root x minus 1 dx. Now we separate it. In the denominator, there are two terms. If we separate it, integration x plus 1 by root x plus 1 plus root of power x minus 1. Now, listen, we skip this line. At first, we write down half into integration of x plus 1 half dx minus integration of x minus 1 power half dx. We skip a one line, it is better for you. We can write down this line as like as, because here the we know if a to the root over a, then we can write down a to the power 1 by 2. If we express it partial fraction, then we can write down this. Now integration it by using first formula. Half into here function is x plus 1 and its power is half. Half plus 1 divided by half plus 1, and here coefficient of x is 1, so no need to multiply by 1. Similarly, half the function is x minus 1, its power half plus 1 divided by half plus 1. Here coefficient of x is 1, so no need to multiply by 1. Now plus c. Finally we get, if we calculate it, half plus 1, that means 3 by 2. 3 by 2. Now, for rough, half plus 1, 3 by 2. Now here half into 2 by 3 x plus 1, 3 by 2 minus half into 2 third x minus 1, 3 by 2 plus c. Now total cancel 1 third. Here similarly 2 cancel 1 third. If we common 1 third, then we can write down x plus 1 होल टू द पावर 3/2 माइनस एक्स माइनस वन होल टू द पावर 3/2 प्लस सी. नाउ ट्राई योर सेल्फ. सेल्फ ट्वाइस. Twice 1, 3, and 4. Now question number 3 number. Integration of sine 7x dx. We know the formula of 1. We go back test 4. Here formula 2. Sin x plus b dx is equal to minus 1 by a cos of x plus b plus c. Now here just sin x, that means sin 7x. We know integration of sin x minus cos x. Now first we keep the minus cos 7x. Now here coefficient of x is 7, so we divide it by 7 plus c. Similarly, 2 number, integration cos of 9x dx. Now integration of cos x, that means sin x. At first write down sin, here x, that means 9x. Now coefficient of x is 9, so divided by 9 plus c. 3 number, integration cos of x by 2 dx. Same. Now cos x, that means sin x, sin x, that